Hey, what's up, guys? We are out here in our little shop of horrors, and we are ready to move forward on one of our projects. You have probably already seen it in the title of the video, but we are going to put the ported GT40s that we got from David some time ago. We're going to put them on the brain. Originally, I was going to put these on the silver car, but I've changed directions. I've got something else I'm gonna put on that, and just the brain is, I've made a lot of passes in that car. I've got a lot of data on that car, so this is a pretty close comparison. I mean, you know, as to what those heads versus these heads will do, that's going to be the only change. We're gonna, like I say, put these heads on, but before we do, we're gonna change valve springs. Now, there's nothing wrong with these springs. They're good to go. David ran them, and there's nothing wrong with them. But I figured while they're off, I wanted to go ahead and put some beehives on. Now we're doing this, we're gonna use the Alex kit. I know that I could piece together some parts from comp and here and there, and maybe do this and do that, and do a lot of different mismatching and put something together. But I just wanted to order something that is all in the package, and I just put it on. So that's why I did that. And in all honesty, that's what 90% of the people do. So we're going to put those on. But I wanted to do it before. I didn't want to put the heads on and go, man, I really wish I would have put those springs on. Just, you know, we're looking maybe for that little bit of extra edge or whatever. And on a side note, these springs, we have another set of GT40s sitting right here on the floor from the junkyard. And we're going to need a set of springs for those. We don't know what we're going to really use them on, but at some point we may need springs for them for something, just kind of a little throw together combo, which basically all our stuff is throw together combo. But anyway, so what I'm going to be doing in the beginning of this video is I'll be taking the heads apart just so I have them ready. The springs are already ordered. They should be here in a couple days. And so I can just start putting them back together. So that's what we're doing. And then, of course, you know, we're going to take it to the track. That's what we do. So let me get to work, and I'll see you guys in a few minutes. Alright, you guys have seen me do this a few times, taking heads apart and stuff. Alright, there we go. David had put a spring cup deal on the intake side, which we can't remove without taking the valve stem seals out. Now, that's not a big deal. We'll just have to maybe, if we need to do that, we'll have to pick some up. But we may not have to. So that's just a little, that's a David thing. That's a science thing. So we've got one head apart. Now all we need to do is do the other one. So David got sneaky too. He ground down the 3-bar on these things. Trying to be sneaky. We're not secret squirrels. All our stuff is an open book. We don't have anything to hide. So all our stuff's, anyone can do it. Anyone can replicate it. See what we're doing? Breaking heads down. We'll show you when the springs come in. We'll start putting it all back together. Son of a gun. We'll be ready to roll. And like I say, on a side note, we've got a set of springs for these heads down here to do something with. So, all right. Okay, we've got them all pulled apart. So you see, this is what I was talking about with the spring cup deal, David. Science, man, science. It's a real thing. So anyway, like I say, he ran these heads for a short period of time. So we're going to try them out on the brain. Maybe pick up a little bit.
we'll see. We'll see where we're at. Then we'll reassess after we run it, see what else we may need to do to try and push it a little deeper into the sevens, or, you know, lo and behold, a high 699. I know that's a pretty big stretch, but, you know, hey, goals. Got to have goals. So, all right, we'll see you guys in the next clip.
Hey, guys, what is going on? I've got a piece of lemon curd.
It don't skate? Bad. I didn't want to say this. The mother bought some yellow cake, okay, in Africa. He went to Africa and he bought yellow cake.
Are you sure?
Yes, I'm sure, bitch. I got a CIA right here. Hey.
Are you sure? Are you sure? I can't believe you.
This tastes ridiculous. Ridiculous. Me and Jeb just coming back from Africa. Cradle him. Celebrate. This nigga out here buying yellow cake
from the motherland.
Are you sure it was yellow cake?
Y'all niggas don't believe me. I got some yellow cake right here. Look, see, leave this.
Don't drop that.
No, I know what I'm doing. So I got it wrapped up in this special CIA napkin.
Don't drop that. Yeah.
Yeah, hold on, drop this.
Pray to God you don't drop that.
Yellow cake.
Right.
Right. Pretty good, too. And small amount of Mountain Dew. Here we go. Oh, yes. I just soaked it. Oh, I spilled a drop of Mountain Dew, though. You guys want to feel that? Come here, feel it. Woo! Bam! Oh, they did that, did they? You guys see what Teresa has put up with on a daily basis. Bless her heart. She's got a heart of gold. The patience of a saint. All right, what's going on? Check this thing out. David. Callie? The hell are you doing? Callie's up in the rafters. Acting like a nutter. David, he would freak out. You check this out, man. It's got a scale. What have we got here? We got our springs from Alex Parts. Shit. From Alex Parts. We got our springs. We got our beehives. We got our retainers. We got our locks. Damn, don't want to lose these. Cost real money. Real money. So, what's the weight difference? That's a... valve train weight is a big thing. Typically on stuff that we're doing, it's, you know, it's not, you know, we got small cams, small heads, we got smaller, you know, whatever. It's not that huge of a deal. But if you can lose some weight in the valve train, that's always good. You always have to balance out cost. You balance out cost versus perceived gain. Sometimes if in your head it's a winner, then it's a winner. So your mental stability is can't put a price on that. So while I had these heads and the springs on them were fine, everything, I really wanted to put the beehives on just for the simple fact, Callie's over there, just for the simple fact of in my head, I felt like I did something extra to help the brain succeed. So, but I was also curious, what do they weigh? So let me get you guys, pull you guys over here and we'll show you the weight differences. Okay, sorry, there's a reflection. This is the standard spring that was on the heads with the retainer and the locks. As you can see, it's 163.18. We'll take this out. Sorry. Here we go, skids. There we go, we're zeroed. We'll put our beehive with retainer and locks. And that's our grand total there, 99.89. That's a pretty large savings. Now, when you multiply that by, well, crap, I didn't even do it. I didn't even do the math correctly. Hold on, I got to redo some math. We'll be right back. I originally only did it for 8 valves, 8 springs, my bad, it's 16. Okay,
This is what the standard spring overall weight would be. It'd be 5.75 pounds for 16 springs, locks, retainers. This is what the beehives will be. So that is a 2.25 pound savings. That's pretty significant in valve train. So it's not insignificant. How about that? Now, granted, this isn't apples-apples test because we didn't run these heads with these with the regular springs to swap, just swapping the BF, see if we got any gain or loss. But in my head, I've done something to help the car, to help it rev, to help it maybe rev a little quicker, to help us get into the, you know, meat of the power band a little faster, and hopefully that'll help us with ET. So there we go. But that is the spring. This is, like I say, Alex spring kit. It was, with shipping, it was like $200, a little bit over $200. Because the springs are like $195 or something like that. So with shipping is a little bit over $200. So anyway, I think it's $208 something. Anyway, that springs locks. Dang it, Callie. That springs locks retainer. So anyway, now I got to start looking at putting them together. All right, we'll be back. Okie dokie, artichokey. We've got one of them done. And hold on. There we go. Let's get this promotional. AlexParts.com. Damn it. Okay, we got one head done. We're out of Mountain Dew. It's probably getting close to, yeah, it's getting close to lunchtime. So we got one done. Still got one to go. All right, cool. Progress. We've got the shop supervisor in here. Cal, what's up? Callie's keeping an eye on what's going on, make sure everything's up to spec. You know, Q1 up in here, quality job one, right? Yeah, cool. All right, cool. Good job. What are you looking at, Cal? All right, we've got the second head assembled. Callie is examining the first head for quality control. She, is it a pass, Cal? Hey, Callie, is it, good Lord, there's some kids over at the park. Is it a pass? Did we do a good job? Huh? Maybe, maybe not. We got us a fresh cup of Mountain Dew, though. That's got to count for something, right? She's just not interested in anything I'm doing right now. Hey, psst, psst. What? Hello, YouTube. All right, we got the second head done. Let's give it a tap with a mallet. We'll be ready to roll with that.
All right, guys, as you can see, we have been hard at work. We've got the wow, that thing's on. I didn't put this on, so don't blame me. Holy hell. Okay, well, let me try and loosen the intake up without breaking it. Good Lord have mercy. We finally got the intake to break loose. Holy hell, man. I didn't put this on, okay? So, like I say, I actually bought this car from a friend back in 2011. And he didn't put the intake on either. We're still not 100. We're still gonna take some persuading. Dang it. He always had someone doing the work for him. Jesus H. Hell. Man. They put some of that sure enough on it. We got it off, thank God. Let me get the shop back and, wow, it's got Edelbrock intake gaskets. Woohoo! Getting our beast on. All right, let me get the shot back out. So, whew, I'd like to have the heads off before it gets dark, but that might not be a reality. So, anyway, all right. All right, here's the beginning of a new chapter for the brain. I'll tell you what, guys, I can't complain about those GT40s that were on this thing. They've been a good head. They have been a good head. Nice. Use a cooling system flush for real. All right, well, we got it off of one side. Now get the other side off and clean everything up. We've got a few other little, we gotta get some RTV, we gotta get a few supplies, we gotta make sure we got some header gaskets. But we've got head gaskets, we got intake gaskets. So at the very least, we can get it all back together. So, progress, a little bit at a time. Here we go. I think that's gonna do it for tonight. We're losing light and it's getting close to dinner time. So I'm gonna put all the tools up and spray a little WD-40 or something on the cylinders and throw a shirt or something over it. And tomorrow we'll get some of our gaskets and we'll start reassembling, clean up the deck and we'll start reassembling it. So.
Well, guys, we've been out here working on the car a little bit. We had to go by the facility this morning to get head gaskets, exhaust gaskets, and a few other things. We had our rocker arm shims in case we need them out there. But we have got the heads bolted down and torqued down. We used the Felpro 1102 or 1101-2s, whatever they are. They're like the cheapest, best compressed gasket you can get. We got them for free. We bought them. We bought some stuff from somebody and they kicked in a set of head gaskets for free. And we decided to go ahead and use them on this. So anyway, but we're on the downhill slide now. Got to get the intake headers, rockers, all that stuff on. So it's fixing to be lunchtime, but we'll get right back on it when we get back. Okay, guys, we've got the rockers on. Like I say, the heads are all torqued down. Rockers are on. David had these heads milled just a little bit because I had to put some shims on the rockers and kind of figure out a shim pack that was going to work. And probably got them shimmed a little bit more than I would probably like. It honestly needs a little bit longer push rod. But this is what we have. And we can always, you know, we can do it later. If we decide to change cams or something, we can really get into it, but I need to try and have it running so I can make it to the track this coming weekend. And it is a holiday this week, so anything I ordered wouldn't be here in time, I don't think. So anyway, we're just gonna roll the way it is, you know, by the seat of our pants as usual. So at least now we put the valve covers on, or get the intake on, put the valve covers on, boom, and we're just getting that much closer. Okay, we've got the headers bolted on, we got the front alternator stuff on, plugs are in it. We've still got to bump it around and drop the distributor in, put the intake on, put the radiator back in it, and hook up the mufflers, and it will be ready to go. Callie, you ready to go to work? We got a Mountain Dew, Puffles out here, and go get them. There she goes. We are getting our butts kicked working on the brain, guys. So my tripod is out at the facility, but I'll have more. We'll explain it a little bit. We've been struggling to get it going, and after a bunch of stupidity on my part, I think we're on the path to getting it all figured out. So we'll talk about it more when I get some stuff done, and I don't, like I say, I don't have my tripod, so whatever. Not that that means anything. So, all right, Puffle, figure it out. Here we go. I'll go through this real quick. We had an intake gasket that was sucking. You can see, obviously, right here, all here, all here. You can see these wet marks. And what happened there? Well, that was a screw-up on my part. I should have caught that 100%. We didn't have the intake gasket dropped down. These tabs hook under the head gasket tab. I didn't have it dropped down. It didn't seal up good. You can actually see the mismatch right here. See how much that drops? That's my fault. I did that and chased my tail for about 3 or 4 days over it. So, man, that is very aggravating, but it's on me. All right, this is on the intake. The passenger side gasket came out with it. You can see I tore the freaking tab off getting it out with this. And this is all clean. Or not, you know, it's not really wet or anything. Now, if we switch, to the other side. Sorry. See this nice little oily residue, and maybe a tiny bit, not bad, but you can see it up in here. But yeah, we were sucking some oil. So, that was on me. Oh, Lord. Worked myself to death with my own mistakes. But never had that happen before, but you get in a hurry and sometimes bad things happen.
We're out here and it's, oh, hold on. Growler's out here with me. You probably can't see her. She's down there. Look at this growler. This is a really, oh, there you go. You want some of this? Look at this. You want some? See, whenever someone's doing a deuce strike, 5 foot, there's a 5 foot radius. You need just to be in the safe zone. Oh, look at that. A freaking leaf. If I was to bury that in the dirt, it would be an oak tree by tomorrow. Just saying. Okay, this video is already really long. I did a little preliminary editing. Jesus Christ. Never has so much time been wasted on so much stupidity. We had an intake gasket problem. Now you guys, I didn't film a lot of stuff that I was doing because I was so freaking mad, frustrated. We went through all kinds of stuff. I had it in my head that there was something going on with the EFI, that it was lightly dusting the plugs. I had all the clues staring me in the face with weird vacuum, fuel pressure acting weird, oily residue it was just staring me in the face, besides the obvious part of being able to see the freaking gasket. I thought I had distributor drive. I chased my tail for something that I should have saw right off the bat as soon as I started the car. I just had total tunnel vision on a problem. And fortunately for me, and I got really frustrated, you know, so you just... fortunately for me, we were at Whataburger after track day and here the other day, and Michael and Kevin were, Michael's like, no, don't ask him about it. He'll go crazy. And I started talking about it, and Michael's like, well, it sounds like it's got a vacuum leak. And I'm like, they don't have a vacuum leak. I checked it in. What about the intake guy? Well, they were right. Kevin's like, yeah, it sounds like intake gasket leak. I've never had an intake gasket leak. Well, you know, I have now, because I screwed that up. Just, that was on me. So, the good news is we got it all back together. We fired it up last night. It was getting dark, and it runs. The plugs in it are dead. I fouled them a couple different times. I'm going to pull these out and clean them again. I could, yes, go to auto parts store and buy some plugs, but I've ordered some with the whole thing with the gasket situation. I'm getting kind of low on gaskets and stuff, so I sent Rock Auto a bunch of money, and I'm getting a bunch of gaskets in, you know, intake gaskets, different types that I use, head gaskets, a set of head gaskets, some thermostat housing gaskets, timing cover gaskets. We've got a camshaft change that I think we're going to do a couple of them possibly. Got a lot of stuff, you know, and I ordered some plugs, ordered two sets of plugs. So yeah, I'll just wait on them coming, and I'll clean these off and everything, but we got it running. The good news is we are on track. We've got it running, so let me wrap this up. I know it's a lot of talking, a lot of dew drinking, a lot of cats and all that kind of stuff. But if you're expecting to see anything else, you're probably on the wrong. Maybe we should change it to the budget cat channel. That sounds pretty good. So we will have an in-car and some stuff when we get it going. So if you just skip forward to the end of that, the end of the video, you'll see it. And that saves so much trouble. So anyway, we got it running though. We are on. Well, I should say we're on the downhill slide. There goes Cheese Puff. We're on the downhill slide. Okay.
All right, guys. You can see these things are pretty bad. They've actually cleared themselves off a little bit, though, from just running the car how I did. So, like I say, I'm going to clean them up a little bit just to help the car run a little bit better. Like I say, they all are uniform. Yeah, they've cleaned themselves off a little bit. It's probably hard to see here, but they're pretty rough looking. Some old auto lights, 764s, baby. So, let me get the other four out, clean them up with a little brake clean, the wire wheel. Don't have one of the fancy little sandbag deals. I think maybe Harbor Freight still sells those, or the old school spark plug cleaner. But anyway, those have, as a matter of fact, I think these plugs were in the car when I bought it. So they're not that it's mileage, I guess, but they're, it's time. It deserves a new set of plugs. So hoping, yes, let's just do that. Okay, well, we've got the other four plugs out. We're also supposed to go meet Kevin for lunch today. And it's also sprinkling a little bit. It's not great weather. So let me go clean these up. We'll stick them back in.
It's all buttoned up and ready to roll. So in our next video, it'll be some in-car. It rained, of course, you know, just enough to make the ground wet and everything miserable. But as soon as we get a chance, our next video on the brain, or our next clip on the brain, will be some in-car and some scooting around out at the test facility, our testing grounds near our house. And hopefully we can get that done today. It's actually a Sunday, no race day today. They had a drifting event. And, but there, that means there's no one out there, so we can be a little bit more free with our hot rodding around. Don't have to worry about, you know, civilians or whatever. So anyway, cool. Thanks for sticking with us. Thanks for struggling through this video. If you did, you know, I don't know why you do, because it's pretty crappy. By the time I'm done editing this, I will have hate seeing myself talk about this enough. So, all right. Superman. We're fixing it right now. We're Clark Kent, or the brain is, and it's fixing to be super brain. Good morning, guys. We are out here. Finally, it's been raining literally for about 5 days now, and we're finally out here with the brain, and we've got us a fresh set of auto lights that we are going to install, obviously. These plugs have been fouled out a couple different times, so while they didn't look terrible, we figured we'd go ahead and put us a fresh set in. That's the way to start the morning right there. Mountain Dew, baby. So Let me get these gapped. Let me get them screwed in. And at that point, we'll be able to go for a little drive, and we can put a tidy little bow on this. And hopefully, if everything goes well, tomorrow we will be taking this to the track. So weather should be pretty decent. It's gonna probably be a little warmer than we'd like, but we'll take a track day. So anyway, let me get off here and finish this job up and see you in the car.
All right, guys. Well, we out here for a test drive, and I actually didn't have the video recording. Maybe I should pay attention to whether the red light's flashing or not. Anyway, I got on it, pulled forth, the shift fork's gone. So we got first, second, fifth, and reverse. So anyway, good news is we're not very far from home. Bad news is we ain't going to the track tomorrow with this. So, dang it. Now we gotta pull the trans. Put a shift fork in it. Son of a... This is why I can never get anything done kind of on other projects. This is the curse of maintaining a fleet of project cars, or this stuff breaks or things happen, you know. So here we go. This car thought it was, you know, made an upgrade and we're ready to go, but now it's one step, it's two steps forward, one step back.
Well, this video has been pretty much a train wreck. You know, car is running good, but we broke the transmission. So I guess we'll go ahead and wrap this one up. It's already super long, so I know it probably stinks or sucks or whatever, but sorry. If you don't want to watch it, or if you watch it this far and you're angry about having to watch it all, I'm sorry. You know, I'm just sorry. So anyway, thanks for commenting, thanks for subscribing, thanks for watching. And until next time, I'm the substandard leader in Fox Spotter Videos, lover of working on T5s, POS Mustangs, 4i's, LTDs, Lincolns, drag vans, 5.8s, convertibles, and Foxes in all shapes, forms, sizes, colors, and flavors. We'll see you guys later on.